Hi, my name's Monty Rowland, and I'm here today at Simply Us Farm. So today has been a busy day. So first thing I had to do was to fix the spreader. I had a problem with where the PTO release wasn't releasing. So had to work on that, got that going, got the spreader going, and then put out lime. So the backfield really needed lime. We had done a soil test, and the soil test revealed that we needed lime. So I've been putting out lime today. And then the other thing I did is mowed. So I mowed the backfield, and then I also have mowed a good bit of the rest of the property. So what I'm doing now is I'm taking just a few minutes and doing this walkthrough, this Gemba type thing. For if you're a practitioner of lean methodology, call it a Gemba. But what I'm doing is I'm walking around the property just to look. So what you see here is that the mulberry leaves are turning, the fig leaves are turning. All these leaves are starting to turn, and the trees are saying, okay, I'm done with the summer. The elderberry leaves have turned. So everything is starting to slow down. This is late October. It's a beautiful day. So being on the farm is always such a learning experience. And this is, I'm definitely not the exception every time. I have a post that's leaning over. I have no idea why that post is leaning over. Right there. No idea. So I have to fix that. So these are the things that you, when you stop and go for a walk, that you see. I had another post that's leaning over up here. I had to fix that a few minutes ago. And I've been mowing the grass, and so I've been zipping around focused on mowing the grass, and it's easy to miss things. So here, this is our cover crop. So we use a Nitro Max mix, which was daikon, which is a big radish, and oats. And then we put that down. Oh, it also has peas. So on the hugel mound, the peas are the ones that are struggling a little bit. Everywhere else, the peas are doing great. The daikon has gone crazy. You can see those big, large leaves and the oats. And so this is our hugel culture mound. So we've got it covering up. I've got this cover crop producing nitrogen, keeping roots growing so that we'll be ready in the spring. You can see way back there, I'll raise the camera up a little bit. You can see that the blackberries have said we're done. The elderberries back there and the figs. So another thing we did was to work with a local tree cutting company. They were cutting some power line limbs, some limbs that were interfering with the power line. So they were more than happy to drop these off a half mile from where they were working rather than have to take them somewhere else. Hoping we can get more of those. So I've put the tractor up, spreader's sitting up. So we're starting to think about where we're gonna grow where next year. But some of the things we had to go ahead and get going. So for example, let's zoom down in here, or not really zoom in, walk in. You can see we've gotten the garlic started, and it is taking off. There's onions and garlic mixed in. Kind of a clump of garlic. Get down here, we'll find a clump of onions. Covering them with hay. Do a couple of things. One thing, the biggest thing is to keep the weeds down. So we put in these cover crops at different times. So I'm gonna go over here. So you can see our header. We pulled up our drip lines. And this one went in later. These got planted later. The daikon that's taken off is daikon that had seeded from the summer. I didn't cut it quick enough. So then the cover crop is a little slower to come in. It has been very, very dry the last month. So when we pulled the crops out, we stopped irrigating. didn't seem to be needed, didn't seem to make sense to irrigate a cover crop. May have to rethink that one. So what happened was is that some of the cover crops you'll see are big and spectacular, and other ones are eh. And so part of that is because two things. One is that some of them went in when it was still very warm, and it was also still wet, and then it just hasn't rained much in the last few weeks. So now we've got cover crops that went in when it was colder, so it takes a little longer to germinate, and then also we just haven't had a lot of rain. So right here are our sugar snap peas. And then I've got a section here. I've got to dig through it by hand. This was a mistake on my part. We were working hard to get you to the end of the day. I left some steel posts, laid them on the ground. Didn't stay on top of the weed eating. And so now I can't mow, so I've got to weed eat them again so I can get them up so I can actually mow safely. Sugar snap peas are doing great though. So we turned this bed here, we had sweet potatoes in it. So we planted a cover crop last Saturday. Hasn't really rained and it's been chilly. So hopefully the cover crop will come up soon. Here's another place where we had another vegetable crop. So one of the things that was in here was okra and beans and peas. Had red ripper peas. You can see right here, this is our cover crop. I believe we had earlier Trombosino squash in here. And it is just taken off. This one we got planted earlier. And so now it had rain and it had warm temperatures, so it did very well. I'm definitely trying to avoid, turned on the fence before I started filming. So I'm trying not to lean up against this fence. So you can see here's our other cover crop. Here is where we had peppers. That cover crop went in last weekend, so it hasn't germinated yet. I'm gonna go through the fence here. I'm gonna do this carefully, so I don't shock myself. Give you a quick tour here. Look at that fence. So you can see here that the figs trees are saying we're done for the season. You can see all the how they're curling up. So we went ahead and put this silage tarp down. At some point I want to have a talk about silage tarps, because big silage tarps are nice, but man, they're a handful to deal with, as we've found out. But so this silage tarp will sit down here until May. Until March. So what we'll do in March is, this has been grass for decades. What we're gonna do is the silage tarp will help kill some of this grass. It won't kill it all because it's not gonna be warm enough when we pull it off. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna put potatoes in here. We're gonna put Irish potatoes in here. So our peach trees starting to lose its leaves are starting to change colors. It's nice and healthy. Planted that this year. That's one of the trees that this peach tree we spent a little more money on. We bought two of them that were about 3 years old in pots. So we kind of took a shortcut there rather than starting from really young. That was one of those cases of swapped money for time. The fig trees grow so fast that it doesn't take long to get them going. Elderberries. We've got more cover crops down here. You see these cover crops are taking off. You see here that, notice the difference. The Hoogle Mound had massive amounts of oats. And this one has less oats, more daikon, but there's a lot, there are more peas. So we have a soil difference. So what we plan to do is to do some more in-depth soil testing. We did the free state version of the soil testing, and not sure why there's a difference between those two. We did have issues this year with our winter squash not performing the way I wanted to, and also the corn. We had the corn that was results that were all over the board. From 10 foot later in this row it'd be green, and 10 foot later it'd be stunted. So we got to figure out what's going on there. So in our community garden, one of the three families said they wanted to take a break, so no winter garden. one family said they want to do a winter garden. And my wife wanted to put in a few things for a winter garden. So we scaled it all back. So this and the peas up here, I'll show you in a second, are the extents of our winter garden. And we've had some things that we had to replant, you can see here. And then also have been picking radishes out of here, which I love radishes in a salad. Here's where the tarp had been laying. So we'll get something sown in here, previous to previous position. One of the things we do is we pull out our cattle panels. So as soon as we're done with them, we pull them out, because if we do it now while everything is green or starting to turn brown, it's easy to get them off the ground and get them free. If we wait, you get all this growth, and that growth will happen down here and it's hard to get them up. So we go ahead and pull those up, put an even number on both sides of some posts that we drove in the ground, which are some of the same posts we used to hold them up. The other posts went in the shed. And here you can see our, of the three, the peas, the oats, and the daikon, you can see different results here too. So we've definitely got some different soil conditions. So this is where we had our okra, and this is where we had sweet potatoes, and we had beans back here as well. And then our sugar snap peas, which one of the tasks for this week is to start getting on these places here. Sugar snap peas definitely need some hoeing love. So one thing I want to throw at you. So we have two engineers in our community garden group. So I'm one, and we have another one. So this solution was did not come from either one of us. So and it goes back to, just because you think you're smart doesn't mean you're going to have all the answers. I certainly don't. And so I'm a mechanical engineer, so I'm well educated, but there's times where there's people that have better ideas than me. And so I want to show you one. So my wife, she saw us, we kept having to, when the way that the company where you buy this material from wants you to do these posts is they want this post directly in front of that post. So previously when we installed these, we had a post right behind each other. So here and here. Problem was, you can't get to it with a lawnmower. Well, my wife said, why don't, instead of having them right in front of each other, just offset them? So now they're offset. What that means is that you can come in here with a zero turn and get most of this path from this side and get within an inch or two of this post. And then what you can do is come from the other side and get in within an inch or two of this post. Now these posts are in a weird spot. It worked out better in other places. But the idea then is now we can cover almost all of that. So the great thing is that my wife made an observation, made a suggestion, and it was spectacular. It makes life a lot easier. So I think it's all one of my thoughts is that everybody has something to offer. And my wife's smart. Don't get me wrong here. But she just kind of came up with that. And she's like, here's what we should do. And she was right. And so, you know, it's one of those things where I'm happy that I have people around me that think about things and think through things and make those suggestions, because that sure makes my life a lot easier. And so I think that earlier in life, you know, I might have been proud and so I didn't think of it as a bad idea. But at this point in life, I'm like, yeah, let's do that. That makes life easier. So my wife was right. She did a great job with that suggestion, because a simple suggestion like that saves time on the farm. And that's really important, because that's one thing you just have a limited amount of. So I'm going to kind of leave you with a parting thought here. This is a peaceful winter garden area. Hopefully our cover crop comes up soon. We might have to add some water if it stays as dry as it's been. It's really been dry, but it will soon, hopefully. Hopefully before it gets too cold to germinate. But this is the peaceful Simply Us farm put to bed for the winter. This is Monty Rowland signing off.